Boudoir photography is a trending, profitable, and beautiful genre, and there are many photographers out there, beginner and advanced, who want to start this genre as a professional business, but they don't know how to start and what direction to go, or they're just hesitant about it. The genre is very confusing because there are so many directions to choose in boudoir and not a lot of information. The reason there is no clear guidance is because no one has really structured this beautiful photography genre. And why no one has done it is because social media is still not fully open to accepting this photography genre. Do you know how many times my accounts have been blocked by social media? How many images were taken down? How many of my ads were never published? How many of my YouTube videos were restricted? All of this just because there is no structure for the social media to implement in their guidelines. Keywords such as sensual, intimate, boudoir, and even lingerie are considered unsafe and inappropriate with almost every social media platform. That is because every person that takes a sexy image adds those keywords and hashtags that we need for our business. As a result, we fall into their category. Now, Believe in Boudoir platform is not just an online photography course. It is a movement to neutralize all the battles against the art of boudoir photography and standardize this genre so the public, social media, clients, and photographers have a clear vision of what this art is all about. So what we want at Believe in Boudoir is to turn the boudoir photography genre into a strong form of art and raise the standards. To do so, we will define it and structure it here in this course together so you can pick the right direction and style when establishing or developing your boudoir photography business. So let's start by defining the genre. What is boudoir? Yes, we all know it is a French word meaning a female's bedroom, but what is boudoir today? Boudoir is a photography genre where women or men are portrayed in an elegant, intimate, and sensual way in a casual setup. Those should be the keywords, three keywords when we define boudoir photography. That's elegant, sensual, and intimate. Notice that I didn't say erotic or sexy. We want to stay away from these words like sexy to draw a line and separate us. This does not mean that we will avoid sexy or erotic photos. We are only doing this to open social media traffic to the boudoir genre. So let's structure the boudoir genre together. First, we will divide it into three categories: niche, style, and levels. Niche is your clients who are interested in boudoir session. Style is your creative vision that you bring to your images and offer them to your niche. And the last category, level, is the amount of sensuality and explicity in your style. Let's start from our first category, niche. Boudoir photography looks like a very narrow niche, but if we look closer, we can actually target and attract so many different types of clients. We have female boudoir, male boudoir, bridal boudoir, couples boudoir, maternity boudoir, self-portrait boudoir, conceptual boudoir, same-sex boudoir, pin-up boudoir, plus-size boudoir, fine art boudoir, nude boudoir, film boudoir, and even boudoir videography. As a photographer, you need to pick your niche and target them. You can also target all of the above. The narrower you get into your niche, the less traffic you will bring to your business, but the likelihood of you getting booked over your competitor is much higher because you are the master in your niche. For example, if a bride wants a bridal boudoir session, she will pick a photographer that is specialized in bridal boudoirs and has bridal boudoir images and keywords all over the portfolio versus another photographer that does all the niches. Let's talk about the second category, boudoir styles. There are different styles you can photograph your subject for boudoir. You can go with airy and bright style, low-key boudoir, black and white boudoir, grainy and film noir look, high contrast and colorful, and so on. What is important to keep in mind is that each style needs to match the niche. In some niches, for example, in female boudoir, we can pick any style we want. But let's say for a pinup boudoir, I can go with a low-key moody style. I cannot go with a low-key moody style because it goes against the nature of pinup images. Now, we know that we need to have a niche and we need to have a style. So how does level work? The level is just a knob with glamour in one side, sensual in the middle, and erotic in the other side. Glamour being the least explicit and safe for social media and public, and erotic being the most explicit and unsafe for social media and public. To better understand what direction you want to pursue in boudoir photography and what you want to offer to your clients, just pick the niche, style, and the level, and focus on building your portfolio within that limit. For example, my niche is nude photography, my style is black and white, and my level is right in the middle on sensual. So if you look at my portfolio, all my images say the same thing, and I attract clients who want that style. There will be a PDF file under this video where I structured boudoir photography so you can download it and select your niche, style, and level to focus on during this course and structure your own boudoir business based on this.